right here doing this, and I was thinking about how so many times in my life I've prayed for something, and sometimes it didn't come true. And I started wondering, wow, why didn't God answer that prayer? And then I got to thinking, so many times in my life I've prayed for something and something else happened. And all of a sudden I realized why God didn't answer that prayer, because He had another idea for something to happen in my life. And that's one thing that, you know, if you're sitting around thinking, oh, why didn't I get to go to that amusement park, or why didn't I get to go to that party, or why didn't I get something? Instead of saying, why didn't I get something, I always remind people that in the Lord's Prayer, it says, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Not my will, but thy will. And I have stopped praying to God that He would give me $1 million, because maybe it would ruin my life. And there's stories of people winning the lottery and their whole lives just ended up being destroyed. But you know what? Rather than ask for $1 million, I'm just going to ask that God's will be done in my life. And if you learn that when you pray, yes, you've got something that you want, but remember, it's not my will, it's not your will, it's God's will. He knows a lot more than we do. So when you pray, the next time you think about it, say, Lord, thy will be done in my life. And you might find, when you're willing to accept what God brings to you, that you'll be a much, much happier person. Let's pray. Dear God, we thank you that you have a will, that you have a plan for us. We thank you that it's not our will, it's your will. And you know what's best for us. Lord, we thank you for the gift you have given us of your grace for going to the cross for us. We thank you that our lives have been saved through you. And we so look forward to your coming again. In Jesus' name we pray.